You can also create a total row for your table data. This is a row that automatically sums the columns in a table, a total row. To create a total row, click anywhere in the table so that you can access the Table Tools Design tab, and then make that the active tab. Notice that in the Table Style Options group, you have a total row option. To select that, simply click the option to turn that on. And notice that now in your data, below the table data, you have a total row that made its best guess and summed the very last column. Well, you can very quickly sum the other columns. Notice if I position my cursor below the tax column, I now have a little drop-down arrow down here in the total row. When I select that, I can choose which function I would like to perform on that column. I'll go ahead and choose sum, and I can do the same thing here for sales. Very nice feature for quickly generating the totals of your columns within a table data area. Let's go ahead and apply this to our project. So go ahead and open or make active the Sales Monthly worksheet. And here you'll see this is our Raspberry Brigade monthly sales report. Go ahead and scroll down to the very bottom of your table data and then click anywhere in the table data so that you can access your Table Tools Design tab. Make that the active tab and select the total row option in the Table Style Options group. Go ahead and turn that on, and notice you do get a total row, and over here underneath our profit column we are seeing number signs. Now the number signs in Excel indicate that a number is too wide for the column width, and you need to make the column width larger. When it can't display the entire number, Excel displays these number signs. Let's go ahead and increase the width of our profit column by coming up here to the border between profit and column H. Position your mouse there so that you get the double arrow tool and double click to increase the width of that column, and notice that now we see what our total profit was. Let's go ahead and create a total for our total sales. So again, select the cell directly underneath the total sales column, select the drop-down arrow, and choose sum. Now, we have some problems with our data. Notice that we are selling some of our products for the same price as its cost. We need to change that. And in some cases, notice here, we are losing money on a product. When you see the parentheses around a number, it's indicating that it's a negative value. Let's go ahead and adjust some of our sales prices so that we are making a profit, such as here for apples. Let's go ahead and change the sales price to $1, and we'll do the same here for bananas. We'll change that to $1. But go ahead and go through and adjust the sales price for your products so that you are making a profit on all of your products. Then save your worksheet and let's move on to the next movie.